Hello students, in this class we are going to see average value concept. How to find average value? AVE average value. We are going to see average value. So let us take an arbitrary signal. Let us take one arbitrary signal. Something like this is of arbitrary signal which is expanded over some limit. Something this is your t and this is your time period capital T and this is your zero. And something for example it is v of t. So this arbitrary signal is having some instantaneous value. For example, if I consider this is a value corresponds to v of t. This is a t1. So this value is nothing but your instantaneous value of your v of t. And if I, this is of one instantaneous value at t2. And this is one more instantaneous value at t3. So if you observe, this value of your vt is changing from t1 to t2, t2 to t3. So this instantaneous value is valid for some time only. If the beyond that time, the instantaneous value is having different value. So this is a called as instantaneous value. This is the instantaneous value of your v of t. This is a instantaneous value. This is your instantaneous value. This is your instantaneous value. So v of t contains some n number of instantaneous values. By using this instantaneous value, we are going to find average value. So average value of this v of t becomes v of t average. Average value is equal to, the average value is nothing but taking the average values of the instantaneous values over a particular time period. By taking the average of the instantaneous value, by combining it, you are going to get the average value of total signal. So v average is equal to total length of the curve. Total length of the curve is obtained by using 0 to, it is expanded over 0 to t. So 0 to t v of t into dt. This is the length of the curve and it is expanded over 0 to t. So the base is t. So from this we can write v of t average is equal to, v of t average is equal to 1 by t integration over 0 to capital T v of t into dt. So this is for average value equation for any arbitrary signal. If I consider a sine wave, a sine wave is nothing but it is a symmetrical signal. Sine wave becomes symmetrical. Symmetrical is nothing but which is expanded over equally in with respect to x axis. So it is expanded equally in above the x axis and below the x axis. So for example, this is your, the value is phi and here you may have the value 10. Here you may have the value minus 5. Here you are going to have the value of minus 10. Here it is a value 5 and here you are going to have minus, that is of 2.5. Here you are going to have some value of minus 2.5. If you examine these values, here you are having in the magnitude, it is expanded equally over the x-axis and below the x-axis. If you combine these all values, what you are going to get? You are going to get a zero value. So if I directly consider, this is a time period. If I consider, it is expanded from, this is your zero and this is your capital T. So this is a time period of the signal, zero to capital T. If I follow with the normal procedure, so what you are going to get, just see for here. So if I apply this same average value, this equation, So V average is equal to, so V average is equal to, V average is equal to 1 by T integration over 0 to T Vm into sin omega T dt. This is from general equation. But this is for general equation. We are considering for specific sine wave. So 1 by T Vm sin omega T, here you can write Vm by capital T 0 to capital T sin omega T dt. So Vm by capital T, what is integration of sin omega T? Minus cos omega T by omega with the limits of 0 to capital T. So from this we can write minus Vm by omega T cos omega T 0 to capital T. So V average is equal to, V average is equal to minus Vm by omega T, just substitute this limit, cos omega T minus cos 0. But from omega, omega is equal to 2 pi f, which is equal to 2 pi by capital T. So from this we can write omega T is equal to 2 pi. Omega T is equal to 2 pi. So here you are having omega T. Here you have omega T. Just write here. So V average is equal to, V average is equal to minus Vm by omega T is equal to, I can write here 2 pi into cos 2 pi minus cos 0. So V average is equal to minus Vm by 2 pi, cos 2 pi is minus 1 and cos 0 is minus 1. So from this what you can write here, sorry, cos 2 pi is plus 1, cos 2 pi is plus 1 and cos 0 is minus 1. So plus 1 minus 1, that gives you minus Vm by 2 pi is 0. So how much average value you are going, you are getting? V average is equal to 0. But this is not the case. So this is a special case. This is a general equation. V of t is equal to 1 by t 0 to t V of t into dt is general equation. By applying that general equation to this type of signal, how much value you are getting? Average, zero average value you are getting. For this type of cases, instead of considering from 0 to t, we have to consider 0 to T by 2 only. Remember, for symmetrical signals, this type of signals are called as symmetrical signal, which expand over equally over above the x-axis and below the x-axis with equal values. For this type of symmetrical signal, this type of signal called as symmetrical signals. For this type of symmetrical signals, if you want to find the average value, instead of 0 to t, you have to consider 0 to, that is of 1 by 0 to t by 2. You have to apply the average value concept only for the half. Only for the half. That we are going to see here. Now let us apply for, let us consider again a sine waveform. So this is a sine waveform, this is a symmetrical sine waveform which is expanded over equally in above the x-axis and below the x-axis. This is your V of t. V of t, and this is 0 to capital T, and this is a point of T by 2. So for these types of signals, we have to consider V average is equal to. So V average is equal to, V average becomes, so instead of considering total waveform, we have to consider half, that is of 1 by T by 2. Instead of T, we have to consider T by 2. T by 2, 0 to
T by 2, same procedure. V of T into T.
So V average is equal to, V average is equal to 1 by T by 2, 0 to T by 2. What is V of T? Vm into sin omega t dt.
So V average is equal to 2 by capital T, and here if I write Vm outside, 2 Vm by capital T, 0 to T by 2 sin omega t dt. So V average is equal to 2 Vm by capital T, just integrate it, minus cos omega t, integrate, that is of with limits of by omega, with limits of 0 to T by 2. So V average is equal to, just write this minus outside, minus 2 Vm by omega t cos omega t with the limits of 0 to T by 2. So V average is equal to, V average is equal to minus 2 Vm by omega t cos omega t by 2 minus cos 0. But omega t is equal to 2 pi. How? Omega is equal to 2 pi f. So which is equal to 2 pi by capital T. So from this omega t is equal to 2 pi. So V average is equal to minus 2 Vm by, in the place of omega t, just write this 2 pi. 2 pi, and here omega t is equal to 2 pi. So cos 2 pi by 2 minus cos 0. So V average is equal to minus 2 Vm by 2 pi. Cos 2 pi, this 2 2 gets cancelled, cos pi is equal to minus 1, cos 0 is 1. So from this you are here, you will get minus 2 Vm by 2 pi into minus 2. This 2 gets cancelled, minus minus becomes plus. So 2 Vm by pi. 2 Vm by pi. So average of this, average of this V of t is equal to, how much value you are going to get? 2 Vm by pi. And RMS value we got is Vm by root 2. So average value of a sine is
2 Vm by pi. Let us see average value, the relation between average and RMS value. What is the
0.22 by 7, that is 2 into 7 by 22, that is 2 by 22 by 7, that is 14 by 22 into times of V1. So 14 by 22, that is 0.636.
636. So for sine wave,
V of t average is equal to 0.636 times of Vm, and V of t RMS is equal to 0.707 times of V1. So from this we can conclude that always Vm is greater than VRMS. VRMS is
V average. Remember, sometimes in multiple choice, they are going to ask you relation between your peak value, RMS value and average value. So Vm is greater than VRMS, VRMS is greater than V average.
So VRMS is equal to Vm by root 2 and V average is equal to 2Vm by pi. 2Vm by pi whose value is 0.636Vm. In the next class we are going to see some power factors and complex power, the terms related to power. After this we are going to see some problems. Thank you.